Now for your active one.
All right. So, Coach, how often, or if you want to say it or not, I would hope you would want to say.
Sure.
All right. So, how often do guys come to the gym and can punch, but they don't want to work on the basics of boxing, like the fundamentals?
Beginners or advanced?
Either or. Either or.
You know, it depends on who you have. You know, I've worked with, like I said, I've been privileged enough to work with some really good fighters, some of the best fighters in the world, you know. And usually the higher a guy's level is, the more they're actually willing to learn. And I've kind of made my system of coaching. I often tell guys, and I kind of market it as if I'm more of a specialist than a boxing coach.
Okay.
You know, so when you come to me, I don't have any full-time fighters. I work with two guys full-time, but I don't have any other real full-time fighters besides Lorenzo Medina, who just turned pro, and then Pistol Pete Dobson, who's fighting actually in 2 weeks in Atlanta. Those are the only two guys that I work with extensively. Other than that, I have guys come in, and like I said, I'm kind of like a specialist where they'll come in, work with me in their camp maybe once, twice, three times a week. You know, I'm not with them every day. So going back to what you were asking, the more advanced and the higher caliber guy is willing to work on whatever it is that you tell them.
Awesome.
It's usually the young individuals that want to come in the gym and think that they know everything and they want to work on what they want to work with. That's the funniest thing I've ever seen in this sport is you got these kids out here that are 2-0 or 3-0 or just high level amateurs or whatever it is, and they want to tell you what it is that they want to work on.
Right.
And I'm 36 now. When I started off as a coach, I would go for that kind of thing. All right, you know, I got to get my experience. And some of these guys have a lot more experience and a lot more fights than I do. And I'm trying to build my name and my resume. Now, where I'm at now, I just don't go for that anymore as a coach, you know. Especially because I've built up a pretty good resume with guys. They know that I have good credentials. So I don't deal with that kind of thing. But yeah, man, it happens. It happens quite often. It used to happen to me quite a bit, and I hear about it from other coaches that I know, guys coming in and thinking that they could just skip over the fundamentals and work on what it is that they want to work on. Yeah. You know,
and that's the reason why I asked, because being young, I saw it, and as an older man, I'm in my 40s, so when I see guys going to the gym and you're looking at them and you're going, yo, my man, you should probably learn how to get your fundamentals straight. Like, you should probably learn balance. Do you know what the yep. why you need to be balanced?
Yep.
During the course of a fight, do you understand why you need to be balanced? You know, and it's just all this, oh man, as long as I can hit, I'll be okay. Like, no.
Yep.
Hitting is the last part. Like, that's the last thing you need to be worried about. You need to be worried about everything else but hitting. Hitting it's should be the last thing.
It's funny you say that, because Rolly's fighting Gervonta Davis, and you know that I know I'm under the impression that they're obviously Rolly's camp is going to be, you know, looking for a big punch, you know. But you, just like you said, man, he's a bona fide puncher. I'm going to give him that. The kid can crack,
no doubt.
Just like you said, he's missing his balance, you know, his proper fundamentals, you know. And I hate that I'm not the kind of guy to throw shade, because I'm not in their camp. I don't know. I would never jump to conclusions. I just, given from what I've seen, it seems like they're going to be going for that big punch. You know what I mean? But they're skipping out on a lot of things. You could be a bona fide puncher, but how do you get to that punch? You know what I mean? If you can't get there, we got a problem. If you can't use your jab, if you can't work, you know, boxing circles, step around on a guy, you're going to have a big time, hard time trying to find that big punch, you know?
Yes, sir. Let's just use Tommy Hearns for instance, the Motor City Cobra. Had a big right hand, but you didn't get it until he was ready, until he had peppered you up.
100% breaking guys down.
Yeah, until he had seasoned you up really good.
Breaking you down. I think that's a huge problem with a lot of coaches these days, man, is they're not teaching the fundamentals like that and breaking guys down and showing them, just like you said. I mean, the first thing I do with a fighter, especially a young kid in amateurs, is I try to teach him balance. You know, balance. their footwork and the fundamentals of how to